happiness is to bring balance and harmony into your lives.
That's right. In fact, if you're using your mind too much, your body will go out of shape. And if you only use your body, you'll have a dull mind. So yoga is a key way to harmonize the two. And for that, there are many beautiful asanas which were designed by the yogis. Some of the postures that we're going to do today are balancing postures. And balancing postures really help you to not only concentrate, harmonize your body and mind, and increase the power of concentration. So let's try out a very beautiful balancing posture called Vrikshasana. You'll have to stand up for this. Take your left leg and take the left foot and place it on the thigh of the right foot. Bring your hands here, balance your body. It helps you to start staring at one particular point. Now bring your arms and keep them on your waist. Get your body into balance. And now very slowly raise your arms up. Feel your balance. Palms facing upward now. Join your hands together. And feel the balance of your posture. And very slowly now take your arms down. It requires a lot of balance even to come back from a balancing posture. And slowly bring your leg down.
Initially it would help to focus at some point on a wall if you're trying it out.
Yes, staring at any point, you know, anything in your, what's around you. Look at any one point, concentrate on it and then get into the balancing posture. Makes it much easier to do it that way.
Yeah.
What we're doing next is yet another balancing posture. Don't you feel that you required all the concentration and all your energy and everything had to focus?
You become thoughtless because you're just focusing on keeping your body straight.
Quite right. So now let's do another posture. You have to face me like this. Take your arms slowly up. Up. Precise movements. Join your hands. And slowly bending forward, aligning your body, stare at that one point, raising your leg up and hold, and slowly coming back out of the posture.
Wow,
that really requires
a tremendous amount of concentration.
So it makes your mind very one-pointed. And later on in your meditative postures, it's a very important part, becoming very single-pointed. So let's do one more asana. In fact, it's one of my favorite asanas because it works on every single muscle in your body. It looks very graceful. It feels full of power. It's called Natarajasana. And the key to it is how you keep your ankles in the posture. So let's work on that. Keep your feet wide. Slowly taking your arms up here, keep your arms straight, bend your knees, come onto the toes, tips of your toes, and keep your hands like this. Can you feel your whole body is engaged in holding this posture?
Totally.
And there are no thoughts in your mind either, right?
Yeah.